In this video, we'll give a quick demonstration of how to use NX Topology Optimizer to design a new bracket for a gearbox electric motor as shown here. We're starting in a part file that already has bodies that will be used to define the functional requirements and our design space. Design space is this volume in green. We'll shift over to that part and we'll start by launching Topology Optimizer. And note that we're in the NX modeling environment here. We'll take a default objective and we'll define our design space. It's already got a material assigned to it. And then we'll define construction bodies. These represent areas that we might want to shell, so holes where we keep a certain material around them, keep out areas that we might want to remove from our design space. And you'll notice how you get visual feedback as the bodies will get automatically trimmed or removed from your design space. And we might also have keep-in regions where we need to keep material, for example, where we need to mount to the gearbox. We want to keep a certain thickness of material. We next need to define an optimization constraint. When you're maximizing the stiffness, the mass limit needs to be defined, which we've done here. And we could define shape constraints, but we're going to go ahead and skip straight to load cases. And we're going to set up some displacement constraints, so pinning it where we need to connect it to the chassis. And then we'll define a few loads. And we're going to define these loads where our part will mount to the gearbox. So for this type of model, we might have a torque to react. So we'll define that first. And we can also define things like forces. In this case, they might represent some of the inertial loads on our part. So we've skipped ahead a bit, defined a few forces. And we're next going to show how you can actually set up multiple load cases. So the subcase manager, which we just launched, is a very convenient way to define multiple cases and activate or deactivate loads and constraints. So we're going to define cases for acceleration, cornering, and braking. And we're going to go in and activate the right loads and the right subcases, which you can do very easily, as shown here. We've now got several load cases. We've set up our model. I'm going to run it. This particular model took about 5 minutes to run on a laptop. And as you can see, you get an optimized geometry. And note that it's a high-quality NX convergent body. We can also review some results. So we can look at displacement or stress for the different subcases. And we can also animate the displacement as well. This helps us get a good idea of how our part is behaving under load cases. We have other options as well to go in and probe results at points with a label command or view convergence graphs. Here we're also going to show that you can define multiple studies. So we're going to clone the first one and we're going to try a different objective. So here we're going to try minimizing the mass. We'll need a different constraint. So we could set a stress limit or a displacement limit. Here we're going to set the limit as 30% of our yield strength for a stress limit. We'll then rerun this. And we've just skipped ahead a bit just to show how you can get a different geometry. You can try running multiple studies and compare them as well. Once you're satisfied, you hit finish. Note topology optimization is just a feature in the tree. You get a solid body, which can then be edited with the usual modeling commands. So this completes just the quick demonstration on NX Topology Optimizer.